युवा छात्र नेताओं में अगले जिस वक्ता को हम बुला रहे हैं, शीर्षा माना वेस्ट बंगाल से बीएससी एग्रीकल्चर की स्टूडेंट हैं, अपनी बात को रखेंगी आज के विषय पर।
गुड आफ्टरनून रेस्पेक्टेड डिग्निटरीज प्रेजेंट इन द हाउस, ऑर्गेनाइजर्स एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स। वेयर द माइंड इज विदाउट फियर एंड द हेड इज हेल्ड हाई, वेयर द नॉलेज इज फ्री, where the world has not been broken into fragments by the narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, it's India. With 1.3 billion people and world's seventh largest economy, India is growing with enormous success in every sector. Recently, our Prime Minister inspired us for making digital India, which is indeed a blessing for our country in this Google era, to step up in a new dimension in the global context. But if everywhere there is growth and success, then why does the question of repositioning India arise? Why our unconscious mind cries, Bharat abar jagat shabai shrestha ashono labe? India is deep-rooted in culture. Here, religion is our soul and philosophy is in our blood. But nowadays, we Indians are developing a very materialistic attitude by neglecting the moral and ethical aspects of life. Due to wastage, corruption, and lapse, most of our government projects remain unsuccessful. We are floating in corruption, terrorism, social inequality, illiteracy, and that's why demonetization has forcefully come today. We have realized that this economic reform has brought a very positive impact in the society, but I think it is not enough. Now, we need educational reform too, to bring back the glory of our country. We all are aware about the privatization of the educational system, which has become a boomerang to us in many cases. All the youths present here today will be agreeing with me that since childhood, we have faced a very business-centric system of education, which mostly produces degree holders with no morals and ethics. That's why it has broken the backbone of our country. We've forgotten the rich heritage of Vedas, Takshashilas, Nalandas. Today, those who have money, they have everything. And those who don't, they feel helpless, insecure, which indulges them into corruption and secondaries. If the government introduces insurance for all the Indian citizens, then it might help to reduce the internal turbulences. Well, it is high time for us to look behind our glorious Vedic era and follow them. In this context, I must pay regard to Baba Ramdev Ji, who silently devoted himself to spread the Indian culture through yoga, which has led to India's betterment globally. Recently, UN has declared 21st June as International Yoga Day, which was possible due to the initiatives of our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi Ji. I hope that our country reveals with wonder soon. It is our duty, my friends, to work for Make in India and fulfill the dreams of our late president, respected Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Ishavasyam idam sarvam yat kinch jagatyam jagat. So let my country awake. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you.
Bahut khoob, Sheersa Manna. आपने अपनी बात को रखा और यही हम सब चाहते हैं कि हमारा देश तरक्की करे और बुलंदियों को छू ले, और इसके लिए आप सब यहाँ पर आए हैं और इसी उद्देश्य के लिए हम सब यहाँ इकट्ठा हुए हैं। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
Shara Hara Dhavala अब कुछ बात करेंगे, मिलजुल कर अब काम करेंगे, आओ अब कुछ बात करेंगे, मिलजुल कर अब काम करेंगे, तब जाकर कुछ बात बनेगी, जनहित की शुरुआत बनेगी। भारतीय छात्र संसद।